I wasn't even ready. But you're already, aren't you, Australia? Welcome to another hour of fun. I know you love the team. They're here and their hearts are going bang, 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 too. So make them welcome.
The other night, a close friend told me, never let my heart go into careless hands. I said, thanks, that's very nice. Appreciate your good advice. But things don't always go with my plan.
Bad, is it? It's only me. I only wanted to sing you a song. Thanks for the memory. We'll be back in a minute, everybody. That was You Spin Me Round Like a Record. This is yours truly, Vince Dale Disco. Spun out and spinning in. Guess what? We've got all the great songs for you tonight. Now, Lorena Navala, please tell me you're my number one.
Thank you. Baby rat.
Isn't it? Hey, do you like my jumper?
Yay!
Well, if I said to you that a very nice 65-year-old knitted this for me, who would you think it would be? My grandmother or someone like that, yeah?
Yay!
Well, what if I told you that this jumper, and it really is a beauty, was knitted by a 65-year-old, but he's a gentleman. And his name is Wal Bramble, and I'd like you to meet him. He's an interesting man. Hi there, Wal. I read about Wal in a magazine. Now, you've been knitting just about all your life, haven't you, Wal?
Yes,
and how long did it take you to knit this one for me?
Oh, about a fortnight.
Is that all?
Yes.
Did you have any professional... Who taught you? Your
mother.
Your mother?
Yes.
You brought in a whole bunch of jumpers. Come and join us, kids. A whole bunch of jumpers for the kids. While the kids are putting them on so you can have a look at it, maybe you can give me a little bit of a lesson at knitting. The girls in the audience are laughing.
Now, what? I've dropped a couple of stitches.
I've dropped a couple of stitches, and I haven't even started yet.
Yeah,
now, one thing I remember my mother taught me is knit one, purl one. Is that the way you do it?
To start, yeah.
To start. Oh, that's for the bottom end,
yeah,
is it?
That's right.
Okay, show me what you do.
Well, go through the front of that stitch.
Go through the front of that stitch?
No, that's the back of it.
Oh, that's the back of it. Go through the front of it. And then...
No.
You show me, Wal. You show me. Have a look at this. This is Wal. Can we get a look at it?
Yeah, well, this is right-handed. I'm left-handed.
Oh, well, do it. How do you do it left-handed? You do it around... Yes. Very good. How many balls of wool do you use for a jumper?
All depends on the pattern.
Do you make many mistakes? Have a look. Isn't he fantastic? Look at this.
Ah,
yes.
You've got to change it from left to right.
I'll come up the farm and I'll check it out with you one day. We can sit on the back, you know, with a couple of knitting needles and have a good time. Now, let's have a look at what the kids are wearing. Now, these are all Wal's designs. Isn't that fantastic? Koala Dan. That's beautiful. And have a look at Danielle's here. Recognize that person? No, it's not Honor Walters. It's Marilyn Monroe. Just beautiful. Ah, yes, and Bevan's a little devil. Hey, did you work those designs out by yourself?
They're not my designs. No. They're what people ask for.
Ah, and Bevan asked for a little devil.
That came out of a comic book.
Good on you.
That came out of the magazine Marilyn Monroe.
Now, here's a very serious question. You use all Australian sheep's wool, do you?
Definitely.
You wouldn't use anything else, would you?
No.
Definitely.
Of course not.
Isn't he a beauty? This is Wal, everybody. Yeah. Click over here, boys.
Click, 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 click. Click, 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 click. Click, 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 click. Great.
Okay, and we'll be back right after this little break with more young talent on Fun. So don't you go away. We've got a new talent for you to meet. Lots of laughs and lots of good times.
And I'll know I'll never find another you. Get it, you, you. All right.
But she's our special magician, Wendy Bergen. Abracadabra! Thank you. Now, tonight I'd like to start off with something. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. It's a tiny piece of sunray. Oh, look, here's some more. And some more. This is great. Do you know what happens to the sunray pieces when they come together? They materialize. Now, because this really is an illusion, okay, it takes two things to make an illusion, my brilliance and your lack of attention. Okay, because this is an illusion and you're not seeing what you're really seeing, that means you're not seeing anything at all. And Bevan just happened to help me. Thank you, Bevan. Now, I want to tell you all out there and Bevan a story, just a little story, all about Red the bank robber, okay? That's right, Red the bank robber, and he's in jail. And these two policemen who heard that Red was going to break out. So they decided to join forces to try and stop him. Now, Bevan, were you ever in the Girl Scout Girl Guides?
Girl Guides.
No, you weren't. What, you're too short? would you say that was a granny knot or a square knot?
Square knot.
Square knot. Well, he's absolutely right. Couldn't be a granny knot. Hasn't got wrinkles. Bevan, I'd like you to hold the two policemen. That's it, above your head, because they have to keep an eye. That's it. They have to keep an eye on Red. Now, while Red was in jail, he made this transporter machine. And he said to himself, as he jumped into it, he said, "This time you've outdone yourself, Red." He said, "This time I'm going to end up in Tahiti, Hawaii, somewhere exotic." So he jumps into his little machine, turns the little dial, and vanishes. Now, let me tell you that the police were very, very worried, because they did actually see him. Can I just have the policeman for a moment? They did actually see him vanish. But the thing that puzzled them most was how Red became handcuffed between the two policemen. Now, a lot of people have asked me, whatever happened to Red? Well, let me tell you, he turned into a real jailbird.
Will allow. When will you get that happy feeling when you are feeling? time, soldier. Have a goldfish, sir.
Goldfish, hey? What would you in tanks?
Tanks. You're welcome.
Get one. What's your name, son?
Scott.
And what's your gag, Scott, and show us your face?
Sorry.
Start again. It's all right.
Where do you find giant snails?
I don't know. Where do you find giant snails?
On the end of giant fingers.
Very good! Hey, Waldo.
Yeah?
Here's an advertisement for lost dogs.
Well, it's no good advertising in the paper for a lost dog.
Why is that?
Because dogs can't read.
Funny. And what's your name, sweetheart? And tell me your little giggle, Marnie.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Teresa.
Teresa who?
Teresa Taylor.
That's deep, that one. It's deep.
Vanessa, I'm sorry to ask this, but why do you say that carrots are so good for your eyes?
Well, have you seen a rabbit wearing glasses?
No.
One and yours?
What sits on the bed and sings?
I don't know. What sits on the bed and sings?
Madonna.
Madonna!
There's no business like show.
Let's get on with the show.
There's no business like show. Business like no. Business like no. Even with the turkey that you know above, you may be stranded out in the cold.
Continually surprises me the nice people we have in our studio audience, but I sometimes get embarrassed because people really do wait a long time to come into our Network 10 studios. And this lady here is our Mum of the Week, Nola Dobney.
Dobney,
yes. Dobney. Dobney, I'm sorry, Nola. Nola's been waiting for 2 years. That's a long time. Hands up, anybody else been waiting a long time?
Yes.
If you're writing in for tickets, please be patient, okay? You're here with your family?
Yes. Rocky's my grandson.
Is he a Young Talent Time fan too?
Yes, and Nikki is too.
Well, we heard that you're one of the bestest grandmas, and that's why we picked you. There's some beautiful flowers for you.
Thank you very much.
Not only do you get that, but you also get a beautiful song from Natalie Miller, who's center stage, and you'll remember this song. It's called Once I Had a Secret Love. Remember that one?
Lovely.
That's for all the mums at home and for Nola Dobney.
Okay.
did you think of that song?
It's one of my favorites.
Good on you, Noel. Oh, she's really touched by it, and so am I. You know, one of these days I'm going to write a book all about the nice people that I've met in the 15 years of doing Young Talent Time, all the people that I've worked with who've driven me crazy. Everybody said that I should be a paperback writer.
Yes.
Isn't that a good cue for a song? Would you read a book written by me? This is Matilda, everybody, and more Australian boys and girls and mums and dads are realising how important our Australian wildlife is to our way of life here in Australia, because it is the lucky country as far as animals are concerned. And this little animal, Matilda, is a very, very lucky Joey, because his mother was killed when it was hit by a car, when she was hit by a car. And a nice policeman picked up this Joey who was still inside its mummy's pouch. And two beautiful people who I love a real lot because they care so much about animals, Vera and Ken Smart, brought Matilda and another little baby along. Would you give them a big welcome, please? And a thank you. You feed Matilda yourself?
Oh, yes. Every 4 hours.
Does she think you're her mum?
Yes, that's why he's not drinking, because I'm his mum.
Now tell us about this one. This is a baby fawn, yes?
He was born last Sunday.
Last Sunday only?
Mm-hmm. And the mother just said, I don't want you.
Oh. Mm.
So she followed me down from the corral, paddock.
Yes.
And she wouldn't go to her mum then. She just came to me and followed me.
Well, they're just beautiful. And
if you've got
any more little animals you'd like to bring in and show our boys and girls to encourage them to look after our Australian wildlife, please do that.
They get a lecture when they come to Ponderosa Zoo on the do's and the don'ts.
Good on you. Well, on the do's and the don'ts of looking after your dogs, I'd like you to meet somebody who's an expert at it. Would you welcome the wonderful Dr. Hugh Worth? Now, this is the doctor on my left. This is Hi, Dr. Hugh.
G'day, John.
Nice to see you again. Today, you're going to talk to us about the boy, how the boys and girls watching can take care of their dogs, right?
That's right. Well, owning a dog is great fun, as you know.
Yes.
We get a lot of enjoyment. But here's old Brandy here, a St. Bernard, which probably cost the owner some $500 when they bought it. He's now a lost dog.
Oh, no.
And probably because when the old owner bought it, they didn't think about what they were buying. Right. A very big dog, probably in a small flat, and now it's a lost dog, looking for a home.
And he's such a beautiful
dog. He's a beautiful dog. He's a real beautiful dog.
Okay, if you've got a dog like this, how do you take care of him?
Well, first of all, good food.
Yes.
Good food. Secondly, grooming. We've got a few things here we can groom with. This is a brush and a comb. He's a very hairy dog, so he needs daily grooming. Also, he needs worming. And I thought that would be something we should do. Show everybody how we worm a dog.
Worms are a big problem with dogs.
A big problem with dogs, and a big dog like this needs to be wormed at least two or three times a year.
Right.
So here we go. Here are Brandy, right down the hatch. And it's a big one. There he goes. Good on you, Brandy. Oh, you're enjoying those, aren't you?
Do they taste all right?
Oh, they taste all right. Oh, he spat a bit out, too.
Now, if any of the boys and girls watching would like to take care of a lost dog like this one.
Yes, well, we've got a few here, John. One there and one here.
Here are some phone numbers.
Another one here.
In Victoria, 288-5111. In New South Wales, 709-5433. In South Australia, 516-931. And in Western Australia, 362-3711. And in Queensland, 480-522. If you've missed those numbers, look in the phone book for the RSPCA.
That's right.
Terrific. Dr. Wirth, I hope all the kids took notice of what you had to say and come and tell us next time about how to take care of cats, because we've got a cat at home.
Oh, I'd love to do that. I've got three of mine.
And I want to ask you a question.
Yeah?
How much is that doggy in the window? That's good fun. Okay, a serious moment now to introduce another outstanding young Australian talent. And of course, we're always looking for fine talented children. So if you think you've got some talent and you'd like to be a new talent discovery here on Young Talent Time and participate in our McDonald's scholarship fund, you drop us a line, care of Young Talent Time in the station you're now watching, and we'll pass your letter on to Laurel Veach, who takes care of that department on Young Talent Time, and she'll take a look at you, and hopefully we'll be able to see you on Young Talent Time, okay? A 13-year-old young man who is just terrific. I'd love you to give him a big welcome, because he's a flautist, a very talented young boy, and he looks great too. Julius Rewadding, playing the flute for you right now. Thank you. you're a good-looking boy. I hope this isn't a personal question, because I encourage young children, if their teeth are any problem at all, to wear braces too. Do the braces interfere with your playing sometimes?
Well, they did at first, but they've stopped now.
You've got used to them now. Yeah. Well, you're a fine-looking young boy, and you're a terrific talent. Here's your check from the McDonald's Scholarship Fund, and we certainly hope you go a long way. And give him an extra clap. He's great, isn't he? And we'll be back to make your pants get up and dance in just a minute. He's just not interested, is he?
No.
He
can smell the other dogs.
He can smell the other dogs. This is Bevan's special spot on the program tonight, and this is Bevan's dog called Ben, right? Now, what kind of tricks does he do?
Well, usually we've got some dog chocks, and he stands up for them, but I don't know if he will because of the dog chocks. Now, Ben, come.
Show Ben.
Come here.
Come on, Benno.
Quick, up. Come up. Come on. You can do it.
Come on, Ben.
Please.
Hey, Ben.
Ben, come here.
Come on, Ben.
Up. You get up.
You're a bit like your master, Ben. Yeah, that's the way. That's what Maggie has to do to Bevan when he won't learn his dance steps, right?
Oh, that's not true.
I'm only kidding. I'd like you to say hello to Bevan's parents, and they're great people over here, Cheryl and Ray Adensall. Get on you, and they're terrific people too. Now, Bevan, we've got a close-up for you, of you, so why don't you go and pop centre stage?
Okay.
Quite seriously, he's a terrific kid, but he never sits still, does he, Ray? He keeps running around. Does he get that from you? He gets it from his mother, does he? Cheryl, do you run around like that all the time, dear Cheryl?
Yeah.
But he's a terrific kid, Bevan. So let's find out a little bit about the behind the scenes of what... Get away from me, Ben. He thinks I'm a lamppost. Here's a behind-the-scenes look at Bevan Adensall in our close-up, and then he's going to sing a terrific song.
Bevan Adensall is the boy from the bush. He comes from Dimboola in Western Victoria, where there's plenty of country for trail bike riding. Bevan just loves horrible, horrific, horrifying horror movies. What a little horror. At school, Bevan was asked to write an essay on the thing he disliked the most. He wrote two full pages about Brussels sprouts.
Not Brussels sprouts again, Mum.
Bevan excels in computer studies. At home, he has his very own computer to compile all his fan mail.
This is an Apple-compatible 64K computer. It's got disk drive and printer. I can compile all my own fan mail on it. Saves using my brain.
Bevan would like to become an entertainer or a physical education teacher. He loves playing cricket, tennis, football, bat tennis, basketball, and golf. What's more, he's really good at all these sports. Look at all those medals and ribbons. It's no wonder his message to the children of Australia is...
Always set yourself a goal in life, and really work hard to reach it.
Kiss me again. You make my pants wanna get up and down.
But before we do, I'd like to remind you all about the very special things coming up at Easter time, because Young Talent Time is celebrating Easter in Wollongong, in Newcastle and in Brisbane, with special Easter concerts for you, for all you people from Wollongong, Brisbane and Newcastle who have written to us and asked us to come there. We're looking forward to seeing you there. And also a very special event coming up, of course, which is our Young Talent Time 15th birthday. Special program that we'll be doing live from the Sydney Entertainment Centre, and it's a charity concert, and we'll be inviting the people from Sydney to come and join us for that. And of course, right around Australia, you'll be seeing it live on Network 10. And that's 2 hours of non-stop fun with all of your favourites from the last 15 years, and of course all the Young Talent team as well. Our thanks to our super special guest stars, Wendy Bergen, Wal Bramble and his great knitting. Good on you, Wal. It's a beautiful show. Dr. Hewitt, Julius Rawadi, our talent discovery, and of course all the kids and their great songs, just terrific. And I hope you'll join us again next week for a whole lot of fun. And wherever you are in Australia, come and join us, won't you? And then why? Thank you, young man. I'll ride home every day. Good night, Walt. And I'll say good night to me. Oh, my love is... Good night, Bevan. Good night, Vanessa. Good night, Wendy. Good night, Finny.
Good night, Tommy.
Good night, Marina. And from all of us here and our sponsors, McDonald's, see you later, alligators.
Bye. In Sydney and in Melbourne, Johnny Young and the cast choose to stay at the Southern Cross Hotels. Our weekly talent discovery shares in the McDonald's Scholarship Fund. Our talent discovery of the year flies Qantas, the Spirit of Australia, to the United States or Europe. Young Talent Time is a television house production for Network 10 Australia. Bruce Mansfield speaking.
There you go, son. Well done.